Is that light okay? Can you, is that,
yeah.
Okay, all right.
That's fine. I'm happy, I'm full of energy. Let's go. Welcome back. Last time, we were talking about one of Dr. Silkworth's core phenomena of addiction and its biological origins. We were looking at his base state that he described as restless, irritable, and discontented. And we showed that it mapped to dopamine tone at a part of the mammalian midbrain called the nucleus accumbens. And we said that the dopamine tone at the nucleus accumbens was made up of three different biological factors: the dopamine released, the dopamine receptors, and the amount of time they have together. More importantly, we said that each one of these biological factors has at least one genetic input, and that people can have this base state and be restless, irritable, discontented. They can have low dopamine tone at the nucleus accumbens. They can have this core phenomena of addiction, having done nothing but been born that way. Now, today, we're going to take a look at Dr. Silkworth's other core phenomena, which he termed an abnormal response, or an allergy, and we're going to call compulsive use. A normal response to taking, as he was saying, a drink, for instance, is to take a drink or two and feel satisfied. And he noted that in his patients, instead of being satisfied by a rewarding substance, his patients at first use gained a physical compulsion, a physical craving to take more of the substance. Let's go back to that diagram and explain why that is. Here's the ventral tegmental area that makes and sends dopamine as a signal to the nucleus accumbens. And the nucleus accumbens sends an I have enough signal to a part of the cortex telling the cortex everything is okay. Go ahead and be generous. But the nucleus accumbens does more than that. So let's add to our picture. When the nucleus accumbens gets more than just the tone signal, when it gets a big burst of dopamine, like from a reward, it sends a signal back to the ventral tegmental area as if to say, thank you. The nucleus accumbens uses the brain's opioid called endorphin to do this. And the endorphin is seen by the opioid receptors on the ventral tegmental area, and this causes the further release of dopamine. So when you get a big reward, the dopamine causes endorphin release, and the endorphin release causes dopamine release, and that dopamine causes more endorphin, and that endorphin causes more dopamine until you get dopamine, endorphin, dopamine, endorphin, dopamine, endorphin, until all the dopamine that was lined up waiting to be released is gone, and the system is exhausted. So all this back and forth between the ventral tegmental area and the nucleus accumbens is called a positive feedback loop. A positive feedback loop results in a very high spike, and the very high spike results in a crash. And if that crash is strong enough, it takes you below where you started. So imagine, you're walking down the street, low dopamine tone. You're feeling restless, irritable, discontented. You know from past experience that a couple of drinks will erase that, make you feel normal again. You don't have any intention of getting drunk. You don't have any intention of drinking a lot. You just want a couple of drinks because you're going to need to feel better to do whatever it is you've got coming up. So you go into the bar, you order those couple of drinks, and you do feel better. But then the spike turns into a crash and you end up below where you started. Remember, where you started was, I need a drink. Where are you now? I need a drink even more. So it's midbrain, not a decision. Your decision was, I'm going to have two. But after the two, the midbrain made a different decision. Because regardless of your cortex's decision to drink two, your midbrain is now screaming, I don't have enough dopamine. And if you don't get some quick, you're going to die. Well, that's the origin of compulsive use. There's a little bit more to explain about this spike. We're going to do that next time. I hope you join me. Until then, be well.